Hi everyone, my name is Sukanya. I am a lawyer by profession. I'm here to talk to you all about my journey, I would say, about dealing with clinical anxiety.
Okay, so how would you describe clinical anxiety?
I would say that every person deals with some sort of anxiety at a level in their lives. It could be feeling anxious about the next project you have to work on, or a relationship, or a friendship, or the smallest of the things that you have to do. So that is something that is very inherent in all of us as humans. But when it reaches a level that it prevents you from functioning, I would say, or it prevents you from as small as eating food, or sleeping at night, or waking up in the morning, and makes it difficult to lead a day-to-day life, is something that I would say would reach a level where you would need help, which is what everybody calls as clinical anxiety. It's a very heavy term, yes, but it's nothing more than something that happens when you leave your emotions about anxiety unattended for a very long time, and then you need seek professional help, and the professionals will call it that you're clinically suffering from a condition. I don't want to call it a disease.
So when you found out that you had clinical anxiety, how did you feel and what was your reaction?
I was barely 21 or 22 years old. I had just finished school and I was on my way to my law school. I studied in Pune. So when you go to a new situation or your new circumstance and you don't know what is going to happen next, the fear of unknown is what tracks the anxiety in. So the first time I would say, if my memory doesn't fail me, is when I, you know, first few days of college, meeting new people, knowing that there is much. I come from a very small town. I come from Amritsar, which is a very small city. Though I've had the best of the exposures possible, I had been a good student at school. I had like the most forward-looking family, I would say, very good friends, and I would like to believe I'm a good-looking girl. So there's no reason for me, if you ask, that why would you feel anxious? You know, you went to study in one of India's top law schools. But that's the thing with anxiety, it just comes and you don't know how it works. So I think when I went there, it made me feel that there's much more to life than I thought there is. And knowing more people, what people are doing from all across the country, it gives you a sense of intimidation. You start feeling that, oh, you're just one of them. There's nothing more to it. You know, that whole high that you've been living, it just goes flat down. So I think that's when it started. But for a very long time, I also ignored it, thinking, oh, this will go, these are just emotions. You know how a normal, any person who would get something, would feel something that is not ordinary, would react to. So that's how I dealt with it. That time I just pushed it on the carpet that, oh, I feel fine, these are just jitters of a new life, and just I moved on with it.
Right. Did you seek professional help? Were you on medication? And would you also, if you were or not, would you recommend medication or professional help to someone who's going through a similar condition?
Yes, of course. I would say that taking help, it may not be, I don't think medical help is the first resort that everybody needs to, and this is very personal to me, I'm not a doctor, but what I feel is that to everybody who talks to me about anxiety right now, my friends, people are close to me, I just feel that more than what kind of help you seek or what medication you take, which a doctor is more qualified to say what level of anxiety you are going through. First thing is that at the end of the day, no matter which help you take, which course you take, until and unless you accept that there is something with you, it is not wrong. I don't want to use the word there is something wrong with you. Absolutely nothing wrong with being anxious. You are only human. If you feel upset, if you have emotions, that makes you human. Nobody, I would say, is always completely happy. So first thing I would say is to accept that you have a condition. Unless you accept that, no doctor, no medicine, no treatment, nothing can help you get out of it. Today, I remember when I realized that I have something like this, I confided in my parents first. In fact, obviously, I picked up the phone, I was only 21 years old, I picked up the phone howling and telling them that I'm going to 10 things, I'm going to do this to myself, I'm going to run away, I'm going to do this, I'm a failure. Every sort of emotion I experienced, and I said it to them. And the only thing that my father told me that time, which is anxiety to me, in like the dealing with anxiety to me is in one sentence, is that it's like when you have a weak eyesight, you put on the specs and you start seeing clearly. Those are the specs that you need to seek from somebody. But unless you decide to put it on every day, or you decide that I'm going to do it, no sort of help will be able to do anything for you. I think the changing point for me with this whole battle of anxiety was that I realized that this is something that I owe to myself, that I know there is something not right, and it is not the level of it is not that I can handle it on my own, so I need some support. The day I decided that, it was, that was the starting point of my journey, not the end of it. It's very difficult. The road to healing is very difficult. I don't say it's a rosy road. At the end of the day, what you do with yourself, how you deal with it, is what is going to be the breaking point. So yes, medical help is important. Medical help does not mean taking medication or being on pills or tablets. It could be just therapy. I took therapy, and that helped, worked very well for me. The doctor told me hacks, which my therapist today, if she sees me, she'll be very proud of me, because all the hacks she told me, I use them till date. So it's an ongoing process. It's not like a permanent state that you have to go to a therapist all your life. It's not like that. Hopefully, I would say. But yeah, so it works different situations, but it starts from you. Charity begins at home.
So what would you say to someone who suspects that they may have a mental health illness? Or maybe like a slight disorder, maybe right. They are just upset or sad. Right. Especially to those people really who live in a small town like Amritsar and are too afraid to talk about it, considering that they may be judged on it.
That's, I would say, the moot point of this whole, a very, very good question. That's the moot point of this whole discussion, I would say. Today, all that I want to start with, and my answer might be slightly long, I'm sorry, but today I'm sitting here, I'm 28 years old, I earn decent amount of money for myself, and I'm not saying these are the factors for somebody who's successful or somebody who's doing well in life, but all that I'm trying to say is that I have been brought up in this city for 18-19 years of my life, this city Amritsar. We are sitting here and shooting it, and I'm very happy that we're shooting it here, because this is where I started from. And when you go out of a small cocoon into a bigger world, it can get very daunting. And especially when you're a woman, I'm saying it because the stigma around being in a place, you know, you have anxiety or you have depression or you have any sort of thing that affects your mental health, more than dealing with it, log kya kahenge is the first question you face with. Luckily, I was fortunate enough that I was blessed with parents who never even made me feel, and this is my request to every person who's trying to support somebody dealing with anxiety, that don't try to make it a big deal. The more you trivialize it, the more you make the problem small, the easier it is to deal with it. Speak up. If you get out of it, you will come out of it stronger and you'll be proud of it like anything else. Today, I'm sitting here in front of you. There have been days when I've been lying on a chair, on a bed, crying for days with a drip in my hand. No food, no water. Crying to my parents sitting here. I'm sitting in a different city that I'm going to kill myself. I'm saying it on record. For what? Because I don't want to get up tomorrow and give an exam. For something so, so small. And I've done it. And today I laugh at it. Today my brother may make fun of me, or my mother may make fun of me, you were being such a crybaby. But it's okay. Accept it, take it in your stride, and face it as your reality. Only then you will be able to change it. There is nothing, it is absolutely normal to feel anxious or to feel anything that you're feeling. The only problem is when we give up. Don't ever, ever anybody should think that mere saath koi bahut badi problem hogi. कुछ भी नहीं हुआ है, ये सबके साथ होता है. कुछ बोलते हैं, कुछ नहीं बोलते हैं. इट्स एज सिंपल एज दैट. एंड आई एम ट्राइंग टू मेक इट एज मॉलिक्यूलर एज पॉसिबल. द स्टिग्मा इज व्हाट मे समटाइम्स मे आई रिमेंबर समबडी टेलिंग मी वंस. आई टोल्ड अ फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन और अ रिलेटिव, आई डोंट रिमेंबर हु, एंड आई टोल्ड देम दैट यू नो आई थिंक दैट that time that I had anxiety was very bad. And she said, you don't have anxiety. As simple as that. Those 3.5 years of my life that I suffered, where I couldn't eat, I would drink water and I would throw that water also out. It was so bad. And as graphic as possible, I'm making it. It was so bad. And somebody just saying it so trivially, though, you don't have it. And at that moment, I thought that, how can you say something like this? I've gone through this for so long and you just said you don't have it. But then I thought to myself that today, the position I am in, I can deal with bigger challenges in life. I have been at a verge where I have felt that I'm not going to wake up the next morning. It's been so bad. So it's not about validation. It's not about what people say. It's about what you think. It will start with you and it will end with you no matter what you think. So yeah, and last thing what I always say is, which I recently found out, is called the worry tree. And whenever anything worries me is what my personal hack. There are a lot of hacks that I use about my how I deal with anxiety. I have an alter ego in my head, in fact, that talks to me when I'm low. Like, I've trained my mind during these years. But I always tell myself only one thing, that if you have a problem and if you can do something about it, then you don't have anything to worry about. And if you have a problem but you can't do anything about it, then again you don't have anything to worry about. So yeah, stay happy, stay loved, stay blessed. And the more you love yourself, more you realize your worth, you will realize that this is all a part of life.